Okay, good morning, everybody. Okay, it's still in the morning, almost afternoon. Today I'm doing a technical talk and sharing my experience as one of the senior system engineer at my university. We are building our single sign-on services with FOSS. Actually, we run the services for more than 6 years right now. And we are upgrading the old system to the new one, but it's the kind of hassle one because we use the heavy stack like CAS, and I will show you in this talk and how to integrate all of the stack into running services, the single sign-on service. Okay. Next, this is our little bit outline of the sort of understanding. But our interesting about single sign-on, maybe some of you already implement, maybe this is the first time. Okay, I will try to explain it a little bit, and also our SSL service and our SSL on how to update our services in the university. Okay, next. This is me. I'm just resigned from the full-time position as system engineer in 2018, and now I'm still a volunteer. And I'm also an activist. I'm a volunteer for our national open source repository. It's called the Kambing or the Goat. Indian for a goat. Yeah. Our data center is like a zoo. Yeah. So there's a lot of animals on the server. It's a goat. Wedus is the name of a goat, but in Japanese, Wedus. So Wedus Lee, Wedus from Universitas Indonesia. Okay, next, I'm also the part-time lecturer there. Currently, I'm here. I'm a senior cloud and infrastructure engineer at Mapan, Koruma. This is one of our social startup in Indonesia. This is an e-commerce startup, but we try to reach people with low buying power. So they who cannot buy cash, and they are so hard to get high quality goods. So we try to connect them with the technology by using Indonesian local wisdom. We call it Arisan. Arisan is like a community group from neighborhood housewife, yeah. And they got a gathering of actually my gossiping or then they but after any community they also form a kind of saving community saving, so everyone in community who would like to access something or to buy something, they will get it from the saving. And what we try to digitally and to help them to from the staffing by using the technology, yeah. And also we build them, the community, we build the community such as our so the community can be grow in economic, so as we educate them to start the such as maybe some food store and some from the guild, they can price the economic higher, and their what we call pendapatan salary. So they can help community other and grow the community. The technology we hope to improve their life quality and in a larger scale. Okay, next. Okay, this is my talk. But we understand single sign-on service for you who never build or never deploy a single sign-on service. This is my little introduction for you. Okay, next. So basically an SSO, single sign-on service, this is when a user log in into one application and they are signing into another without log out again. So the regardless of the platform, actually or domain where this user comes from. So it's like a Google account, a single account. So lots of service in Google, but use single account. So there must be some trust center or trust server or trust repository where you can secure the secrets and single sign-on system. Antichrist yang sang out to God and in sort of God one of the and then the movie about drama present. Example, you can be the widespread use like the Google account platform. Okay, next. So it's kind of like this, the flow. So it says, so involves several parties. There's a user in here. And there's identity provider. This is the secrets. And this is also the provider of the identity. And this is also the grantor who grant the access card to the requesting apps. So the user must log in to the requesting app and the requesting app request the identity of the from the user from this identity provider, and the identity provider grant it the authorization for the apps. Okay. Next. So yeah. User access an app, protected by SSO. The app gives a user and redirection to the IDP side. So this is the command for IDP, identity provider. The user access the IDP with his or her credential, and the credential keeps or store the IDP. So the because the app don't usually get the identity, it only get the kind like authentication token or tickets. The user has to sign in to the apps with his or access card. Okay, next. This is some of the open source implementation of free open source software. The, one of the most popular one, I think, this is the Zcash Aperio. This is one mostly heavy one, and we use this in industry. I think if you familiar with EduRoam, the education roaming. They also based the software with Citas. The some the university from the Asia Pacific Rim University, APRU, they use the EduRoam and they use the rooming account from one university into another one. I think this is the same. So just standard the protocol or standard central service. This is the protocol used by Citas. This for the web. And this is also Holy Hydra. This is mostly for all out only protocol, the Holy Hydra for Justice Lux. It supports just protocol, SAML, OAuth, and Lux. Also, Symbolet. This is also used at the EduRoam. And this is WSO2, the latest server from the WSO2. This is the you know, kind of enterprise service bus, WSO2. Okay, next. Yeah, this is part the S1 upgrading single sign-off service at the University of Indonesia. Next. This is our university.
Oh,
okay.
No.
Oh, it's too dark. Now we are located in Depok. It's southern part of Jakarta, but we also have the Somad Pahoti on the Jakarta, central Jakarta. We see Jakarta di Depok area. Yeah? We currently have 47,000 students. Roughly, this is from the undergraduate to the graduate and the doctoral school. 47,000. And we have more than 6,000 staff. 14 faculty, 1 professional school, and 2 interprofessional graduate school. More than 227 study program. Management for hectare at the Jakarta and 320 hectare. That's including the what we call a city forest. Yeah. We have the kind of small forest there from the Jakarta and Depok. Okay, next. Okay, FOSS, our free open source software, is our soul. So mostly because one of the our teacher is founding member of from Indonesia Internet, and he also the founding is also increase of money community. So he from Debian Indonesia. His nickname also RMS, but it's 46. RMS 46. It's our lecturer. One of our lecturer the Faculty of Computer Science. He is one of the founding member of Debian Indonesia. So the UI, the University of Indonesia, we build most of our solution on top of free open source software. And we believe that collaborative work, of course, are easy to enhance and maintain, combat the loss of proprietary system. And we also, this now available indicator, our system. And we are also maintaining one of the largest proprietary server. Now it contains at least 20 terabytes of most of the open source project from most of the Linux distribution, database, language, DLC, Python, and also some of the Raspberry Pi repository. Also, we have the Kambing with this.
That's cool.
Okay, next. This is the application page. So you get a Wi-Fi in your NFT this day. So our single sign-on services. We started using the first. We started using OpenAuda for a single account for student. This is our my founding mother of the Debian Indonesia, Mr. Ramesh, who set the single sign-on Auda account. The FRS have to build their own surface to OpenAuda. This is built for credential inventories. Yeah, because sometimes people forget they have to encrypt the connection to the OpenAuda and they don't do it. Even so, this is will cost the credential inventories. From 2010 and 2012, we are pressing SSO solution with the systems credit. Berintakan will version 3. This is also the running production of version 3. We deploy SSO on SSO utilities in the CTAS for the 3.4 and we customize for our needs. Okay, next. We update to TASPA 3.5, it's widely used. Even the Microsoft Office application uses SSO, using from the XML protocol. But you have to proxy the connection to the Microsoft ADFS. Of course, we developed the second application as backend, and we, also we developed this login attribute because the task can give you an extra attribute, such as is this student an active student or not, or this staff are active or not. The can give probably the additional backend. We start this staging phase now for task 5. Next, this is our production stack. So every app connected to the SSO. The front end of the JAS is built using the Spring, Spring framework Java. So JAS handling the ticketing, the operation token, the authentication, and the we have the backend tree. We have the LDAP. For example, we have LDAP and the Xpandigo. We use it. We use LDAP and database. So this LDAP. The authentication provider and also the Drupal database, which is the MySQL based authentication. So the Drupal service handles the authentication and just receive the authentication, the authorization. Okay, next. We need to update to task 5. Why? Because we need more connection backend, because one, the EduROM is ready, and the task 5 support that. Support multi-cache protocol besides on JAS protocol is kind of all out because we have mobile apps even now, and it's all out. The JAS 3 don't native support, don't have native support on that. And no more flat text configuration. We have persistent configuration now. So database. And also service registry provides some GUI, but I don't succeed to deploy the GUI for during this time. But it also support custom REST attribute mapping. Now we don't have to build another Java class code to interpret the attribute from REST, but we use the Groovy as the front line from the task to map the REST attribute to the IDE server. And ticket storage can now use lightweight backend such as Redis, because the previous one used heavy MySQL and Postgres. For ticket we don't need that, because the it's a issued per session based, and Also the ticket, granting ticket, or the head of the ticket organization is issued or expired daily. So we don't have, we don't need some of the persistent of the MySQL clusters. It's about Redis, you know, in memory. We use embedded service container, directly built. This, it's built from this frame now, this frame, this frame, and now built-in embedded container. So we can use, and it's Tomcat, Jetty, Undertow. Was for this development, I use Undertow because it's lightweight, but then Tomcat or Jetty. Also, it support cluster deployment as long as we have a same registry service backend. So we can cluster the IDB server. Next. You see the proposed architecture, I use the big campus. So this is the IDB service and the ticket storage, the session ticket, the ticket granting ticket and the session ticket will be stored in Redis. Previously we use store this in Postgres. And this but heavy, we destroy the database every night. We use now the in-memory Redis. So we use PostgreSQL for the service security, and also we have the service tracing manager. This is the GUI interface to manage services, add and remove from the IDP. Also now we have the LDAP backend, and the other backend will be added. So the personally used SQL based database from Drupal, as the same. Okay, next. Sorry, I must add a little bit. This is the relevant step. Yeah, I don't use Docker about this one. So this is still a hassle because the build process from the test, the Docker image provided from the Aperio is not suitable for our use. So for this staging one, I use the manually for. So we have first to deploy the IDP service, enable the PostgreSQL for registry service and storage. So we have to deploy the more ticket and internet in other. Okay, next. Recap some VMs. Also, we put spec. We can change it. Example with 4 core and 8 GB RAM because we running Java 5 then. JDK already installed. Minimum was JDK 1.8 for this Java 5. And we have a valid SSL for the connection. Already converted to format VPJS 12. So how to install? First we, this is the method, source method new one. Because the first one we have to clone the target repository and build ourselves. Now the Aperio just use Gradle build, the overlay build. You can use Gradle build or Maven. First we download the overlay, unzip and okay, next. The part you must change, the build Gradle, see the part, this one, which container, server container you want to use. I use Undertow because it's more lightweight in the Tomcat. Then we compile just. Set up a basic configuration. We have to get the directory of the /etc /etc. And we press system the services, everything okay. We can run the initial IDP server, but it's built with test user, it's test user, and this is the default user from the Aperio Chas. Okay, next. This is the configuration, basic configuration. So you have to declare the server name, of course, and the also the prefix. Slash class is the prefix. Well, so we call the authentication service will be detected to that. So the login, and this is the SSL part where you store your tstore for the SSL services. If you want to terminate the SSL, but later we don't want to terminate the SSL directly to the chas, we will use Nginx in the front. So the chas will get the plaintext, but the term will be terminated in the front line. We'll use Nginx to terminate the SSL. Okay. Next, this is the system service. And the command you have to. This is the word file. When you put the word file, this is the word file provide, created from the build gradle. Just call it. It's already contain Servlet container and then worried the configuration you are declared in the SYCT CTAS. So the system is service. So minimal you have to run it with the public memory. Yes, this is one of the recommend the public memory is the base memory for the task service, but it's quite handy. I usually run several hundred to authentication from 600 to 800 authentication rate per second. And it costs me like a little bit like 10 gig memory. Okay, next. Yeah, this is the result. And we still get the warning because we still set the default user ID. So you don't, you have to disable the default user. So you have to, this is the staging phase, the single sound service, this is the desktop. You can customize this way using your own template style based on your need. Next, Redis and Postgres, this is the backend storage. For Redis, we need the RAM, especially because we the authentication are folded, and yeah, a little bit like this, 15 GB or 24. That depend on your needs, on how much you authenticate seconds. Because like this, we store the ticket, grading ticket. If this longest ticket will grant session. And so service ticket, this is per session. Okay, next. Yeah, I still use Debian again, but you can use last, what you say? It's okay. But my this is the one of the founding of Debian. Yeah, this is a nice download Debian, and this is the initial Debian. And you add the configuration, next. Okay, see. Yeah, you recompile, you add the build cradle of this library, JDBC driver, and JPA per system for the service registry. And recompile again, the build command of the cradle, next. You have this configuration, you have the just property, and it will migrate automatically. When you restart just server, it will migrate automatically with the MP schema. Yes, you restart the service and you get connection. You get this schema. It's a service, service property, service contact, property, and then you will get this schema. It's automatically migrate. Okay, next. Now Redis, we have to bind the Redis to the Debian, mostly define the local host. It's bind to local host, so you have to bind the public port. And you have to use the password, because we are getting the network. And you add the dependency again. Support Redis ticket registry at the JAS. We compile and we start. Okay, next. At the configuration like this, the crypto encryption key and crypto sending key, this is a JWT token, JSON token, so you can write this with a kind of JWT tool, JSON token, and you connect to the Redis with the host and password. Okay, start your JAS ID. It will connect. And for the LDAP, at the support, LDAP support. I don't bind the directory. I don't bind, and this is I used to tunnel the connection using S-tunnel. So it tunneling to the LDAP support. We just bind this root directory, root key, the base DN, and this is for the user search. Okay, we start. That's it. You can try to use. Wait.
Thanks.
Okay, next stage. Okay, for the EC testing, we can write all apps to the system test protocol, or maybe you can deploy itself as WordPress. It's easy, and using this WebHSPy. WebHSPy is the plugin for the consume the IDP server. Yeah, next step, this also should be a Docker or someone to easy more easy deployment. And the registry web manager. Without the registry, you have to insert it manually to the first base. So maybe time should have the registry manager. Okay, thank you, and please, if you have any question. Any question? And I'm sorry, I don't do English so good. But if you're curious and want to know how to more deploy and what to use single sign-on surface, feel free to contact me. Email, and I will upload this slide on Slideshare and also share the technology, the OpenCCA ACM. Thank you very much.
Yeah.